The Cajun Cannabis Conundrum. In Louisiana, the legal medical marijuana scheme is a mess. Physicians' hands are tied by state regulators, and there's not enough pot to go around for the patients who need it. Despite being a historically conservative state, Louisiana first legalized medical marijuana back in 1978. It amended the law in 1991, then left the program to wither on the regulatory vine, with the Department of Health failing to appoint a marijuana prescription review board or to draw up contracts with national groups for production and distribution. That began to change in 2015, when Republican State Senator Fred Mills, a pharmacist and the former executive director of the Louisiana Board of Pharmacy, sponsored legislation to implement the distribution of medical cannabis to patients. In 2016, Mills sponsored a second law that laid out the program's specifics. Both bills eventually passed the State House and Senate and were signed into law by former Republican Governor Bobby Jindal. In early August, Louisiana officially became the Deep South's first state to dispense medical marijuana. In theory, the program is working. Roughly 1,500 patients in Louisiana are receiving medical cannabis. But some 5,000 patients have consulted with physicians about the program, and there doesn't appear to be enough legal marijuana to go around. Advocates say that's because a series of compromises among lawmakers, the Louisiana District Attorneys Association, the Louisiana Sheriffs Association, and conservative Christian groups have made a regulatory disaster of the law. Mills says he originally intended for the legislation to be more of a free market system. It's not. Under state law, only 9 pharmacies in 9 zones across 52,000 square miles received permits to dispense medical marijuana. Smokable and edible versions of the product were banned, as was vaporization. Oils, tinctures, sprays, pills, and gelatin-based chewables are allowed. The Louisiana Department of Agriculture and Forestry has licensed just 2 growers, GB Sciences and Alera Holistic Healthcare, to contract with the agricultural departments at Louisiana State University and Southern University, respectively, to produce medical cannabis for the entire state. As of this writing, only LSU's operation is producing medical marijuana. Southern University's first crop isn't expected until later this year. Despite advocates' pleas, only certain doctors are allowed to recommend medical cannabis to patients, and the state created a list of qualifying conditions rather than allowing physicians to use their discretion. I've always testified that this should be a decision 100% between a physician and a patient, and if somebody has a debilitating condition, then why should government get in the way? Mills says. But he was forced to change his approach. The only way I could get the legislation passed was to work cooperatively with the law enforcement community. I think if we hadn't done what we needed to basically take an approach of crawl before you walk and walk before you run, I don't think we would have passed the legislation. Kevin Caldwell, the president and founder of the cannabis reform group Commonsense NOLA, says the current system is unsustainable, an outcome his group warned of early in the legislative process. But nonetheless, that is how things were decided, because the Louisiana District Attorneys Association and the Louisiana Sheriffs Association are the kings of the Louisiana legislature. Patients and advocates were excluded from the regulatory process, Caldwell says, and it shows in the state-run market. A 30-milliliter jar of THC tincture costs between $180 and $220 at certain medical marijuana dispensaries, 3 times the price found in states where recreational adult-use cannabis is legal. What's more, he adds, a lot of the sickest patients that want to use the program are on Medicaid and don't quite have the money for a $200 visit and then the follow-up visit. Restricting how many physicians can recommend cannabis has likely made the cost of obtaining a recommendation more expensive.